Good evening. As Mr. Sameer Saran invited me to speak on this occasion, which is practically the fag end of the entire two-day-long, very marathon session, it beats my imagination what is it possible that I can say here, which you may not have heard, and which you may not have heard from experts who know much better in the respective areas. The only thing, therefore, which I wish to do now, both in the interest of time, at the same time keeping the interest of the audience in what I'm saying, is to take you through my thinking process as to how I see cyber diplomacy. I'm emphasizing the word I because what I think, what I propose perhaps will be disposed by my bosses later. So to that extent, it gives me the full liberty to say whatever comes to my mind. Some of the things which I would say are pretty obvious. What is this diplomacy? If I were to be able to live in this cyberspace without needing anybody, without being impacted by anybody, perhaps diplomacy would have practically nothing to offer. But we know that for a wonderful cyberspace, the pushing can be here, the impact can be entirely on the different side of the whole world. And therefore, that is when this pushing can be both positive, that is what we are all accustomed to, that is what we are all addicted to. The country, particularly under the leadership of our Prime Minister, for the past 4 years has been investing heavily in the area of digital economy, digital services to the population. Earlier, it was only notional on paper, but since 2014, with emphasis on variety of programs of which you must have heard, I will only coin the names Aadhaar, Mobile, Jan Dhan, etc. We have taken this platform to deliver services to our people. In fact, I would venture to even say that the governments today, I am part of it, are extremely proud to say that we have been able to put together something which is actually delivering welfare, prosperity to the people, not in the cities, not in the big towns, but right to the last population. And there are many statistics which have been compiled and in an authoritative fashion been relayed to say that this platform has been extremely useful. This is a platform which has empowered our people who were otherwise somewhere there waiting for the leadership to take a decision without knowing what will happen to them. The point I'm making here is that having invested so heavily in this kind of platform, we have also created a monster for ourselves in the sense that now we have a responsibility to make sure that the fun continues, the spoilers do not get a chance to spoil it. Now that is where the cybersecurity element of it comes. As we speak, the entire army of various officials in the government of India, as also in the various states of the country, they are working over time to make sure that we do all that we can to keep this space secure. We have just heard a conversation on the data. That is where I would take you that if you recall a history of India's developmental path in the digital economy, we benefited immensely from the fact that we collaborated with the rest of the world. Now that is where, even if you talk the maximum, the services IT, enabled services and IT, it all basically is exports which we have been been benefiting the country. The data would be one of those elements. We have been beneficiary of this transaction happening, so data also has to be in a fashion that is compatible to the world standards. It's no longer that the company is doing something good and thereafter what they do would not impact me. We have been impacted to that extent. As we say, that whereas this is like a knife which has double edge, it can benefit the population, at the same time it can also harm you tremendously unless we are careful. And that is where one of the elements of which we have seen is the Sri Krishna Committee report and the draft bill, a huge criticism. But let me tell you, this is honor to the country's democracy that we have actually permitted this whole discussion to happen. And our Ministry of Information Technology has floated this another thing which happened via, again, digital platform. And the draft bills which are actually now introduced, they are thrown open to the people to comment. No, something, it's participatory democracy. The people can comment as vocally as they did just across, as we heard them. The criticisms will all be heard, will be factored in. There are all sorts of opinions which come, whether the data localization, the mirroring, whether we have the wherewithal, the infrastructure in the country to really have that mirroring take place in the country, whether that will cost huge amounts of money that will be required to put that thing. So if you, depending upon who you listen to, one section will say that it is extremely useless exercise with very limited intent in its mind, whereas what is happening without any mirroring is also pretty good. Another person will say actually that it's not necessarily that rocket science will be able to put all those football size servers, etc., to go through. The limited point here again is that the process which we are following, example in front of you, is to allow all the people, the stakeholders, to comment in the hope that what we have is something which is not only meeting the requirements of our stakeholder, but also that it is compliant with the world standards. Invariably, we get into the world aspect because my data, if it is great according to me, but nobody else really believes in me, it would not really take me too far. We really wish to collaborate with others. We want to exchange freely for promoting innovation. That is where I come to my last point, which I'm wanting to make here, that having benefited from the India's IT sector development actually began precisely on the private sector. It was entirely private sector led till governments came later, which essentially means that our trust and faith in multi-stakeholderism has a history behind it, that we really believe that this is an area where the private sector, the experts, they need to come forward. And this is a time where the governments half the time do the catching up, in the sense that technology really moves ahead even before we have understood the present scenario. As we talk of the cloud services, we are suddenly presented with the edge services, you know, something like that. Edge computing, cloud computing is something. Now the edge computing is taking you back to the local. We were talking of keeping our data somewhere in San Francisco, Singapore, but suddenly we have been told that with the Internet of the Things, the Industry 4.0, the most important, of course, the 5G communication technology, the most important thing would be for us to keep the communication reliable. And that will be happening only if it's edge computing. And we already talk of artificial intelligence and the loss, that is lethal weapon, autonomous weapons, etc. All those things are throwing, challenging the government officials like me who hardly have any knowledge of the subject. At the same time, those who have the knowledge of the subject, they are not necessarily sitting in the diplomatic table. And we are sitting on the table when we don't have much knowledge. It's a huge battle. They want to educate us, and to the extent we try, and this is what we do. Coming back to the latest state of play of the discussions in the world arena, you may all be aware, there was UN mandated governmental group of experts which sat together in a smaller group. Now the idea is that the discussion, wherever it was left, should be taken forward, perhaps this time expanding the group of people who comment on it to larger. It's a 194 country UN membership. It cannot be left to only 25 members who sit and decide and say that this is the kind of template which we need to use as we talk of norms of behavior, etc., etc. Now that is where we are. 2017 was the last when this group of experts met, but we have to yet constitute the new group of experts, and we are pretty confident that the ones that is constituted, it will be able to pick up the threads and take forward, so that, as I said, the fun is on and the spoilers are off, and we will be able to benefit from this wonderful cyberspace which has suddenly empowered all the sections of the population all across the countries. Thank you very much.